Hi guys, so today another vacancy by RBI has been released. It's called, it's for a list of, there's a list of vacancies for different posts. And there are two posts specifically which are very interesting. One is based on finance and another one based on HRM, human resource management. Now, both these posts, or in fact, all the posts that I'm going to list here are specialist posts, and you need to have some specialized master's level or MBA level qualification in order to be qualified or eligible to apply for those posts. It's going to be a two-phase based examination, where in the first phase will be technical in nature, which will include all three, which will include your English capabilities, writing capabilities, descriptive capabilities related to your specialization. And the third one is objective-based capability based on the specialization that you have. And the second phase is going to be an interview. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to do the going to go through the entire notification, plus I'm going to go through the entire syllabus also for all the 6-7 vacancies that have been released, and we'll try to have a look and find out what all other things that we can cover, and what all other things that we do not have specialization to be able to cover, and you have to do it yourself. So let's go to the RBI website and see the notification first, and then we'll have a look at the syllabus which has been released by the RBI. Okay, so here you can see direct recruitment for the post of specialist in grade B in common seniority group streams 2018. What are the important dates that you have to keep in mind? Number one, August 17 to September 7, the registration process is going to be open for this time period. The examination will be held on September 29. It can be changed in the future also, but as of now, September 29 is the date for examination. On a single day, three papers are going to be held. The first paper will be objective. Second paper will be of English. It will be descriptive in nature, but it's going to be computer based. And the third paper, it's going to be offline, not online. And third paper also will be descriptive in nature. It will be based on the specialization that you have. We'll have a look at the syllabus also for all the vacancies. Then it will become more clear. Okay. So these are the important dates. Please apply for these posts within these dates only. So the number of vacancies in all these specialist posts are as follows. Finance, there are 8 vacancies for general, 2 for SC, 1 for ST, 3 for OBCs, total of 14 vacancies. Data analytics, also 8, 2, 1 and 3. Risk modeling, 8, 1, 0 and 3, 12 vacancies. Then you have forensic audit, a total of 12 vacancies. Professional copy editing, 3 and 1, 4. Human resource management, also less vacancies, 3 and 1, a total of 4 vacancies here. So these are the number of vacancies. A total of 6 posts have been opened for recruitment, and a total of 14, 28, 38, 40, 52, 56 and 60. 60 vacancies in total have been released. Let's move down and see. These are these you can go through yourself, not very important. Pay scale, we'll have a look at it separately. It's the same pay scale as of grade B, so not much of a difference there as well. They'll be joining as specialist in grade B, so same level. Eligibility conditions, these are the basic eligibility conditions. The age limit, yeah, this is important. So the age limit is must have attained the age of 24 years and not 21 as in grade B, and must not be above 34 years of age. So 24 to 34, these are the 10 years within which, if you like, you can take the examination. Up to a maximum of 5 years for candidates belong to SC. Maximum age indicated above is for general. Relaxation is also provided here. 5 years for SCST, 3 years in case of OBC, 5 years in case of Jammu and Kashmir citizens, and 5 years for ex-servicemen, including commissioned officers, all these. So total of 3 to 5 years of relaxation is also provided here. Let's move down and have a look at some other important things. Okay, so these are the qualifications which are required if you want to sit for these examinations. So for finance, essential. So these are the essential qualifications. These post qualifications work experiences are not important here, because if you have them, you will not have to work as a probationary for a probationary period in the organization. If you don't have them, even then it's not a cause for worry, because you are eligible to write the examination if you have these educational qualifications. Now, what are these? Number one, for finance, 2-year full-time postgraduate degree in economics or commerce or MBA in finance or PGDM with finance specialization from an Indian university with at least 55% marks. So master's in commerce, master's in finance, master's in economics, MBA in finance, PGDM in finance with at least 55% marks. And these desirable qualifications are going to be helpful when you go for the interview. The next is data analytics, 2-year full-time MBA in finance, MSTAT from an Indian university recognized by government bodies or a similar foreign with at least 55% marks. Risk modeling, again 2-year full-time MBA in finance, similar. So data analytics and risk modeling, same qualification. Forensic audit, CA or ICWA with certificate course on forensic auditing and fraud detection conducted by ICAI. So you need to have this certificate course. If you don't have this certificate course, then you're not eligible. Professional copy editing, full-time postgraduate degree in English from an Indian university. So you need to have a postgraduate degree in English if you want to sit for this examination under this post. Human resource management, postgraduate diploma or master's degree in HRM, personal management, industrial relations, labor welfare from a recognized university with at least 55% marks. So for HRM, master's in finance or master's in commerce or master's in economics is not going to work. You need to have a specialized master's in human resource management or personal management or industrial relations. And the seats are also less there. Okay, job profile, finance, you're going to work in the finance department and look for stress testing of bank balance sheets, basically identification of NPAs and identification of various scenarios wherein NPAs could have been avoided, all those things. Data modeling, in the data analytics and risk modeling based on risk management. Forensic audit for auditing. Copy editing for proofreading and human resource management, basically the HR department of Reserve Bank of India. Number of attempts, total of 6 attempts are the maximum that you have for general candidates. There is no such restriction for SCST, OBC, the posts are reserved for them. So no restriction on number of attempts for SCST, OBC and PWD, but maximum of 6 attempts for general candidates. Scheme of selection. So these are the 3 papers. The paper 1 is going to be online, paper 2 also online but descriptive in nature, and paper 3 offline and descriptive in nature. Paper 1 will check the professional knowledge in the area of specialization, finance or HRM or economics or data analytics or auditing. Paper 2 is going to be generic, writing skills in English, which will include your Prezi, essay, comprehension and some other things. And paper 3 is going to be again specialized in nature but offline and descriptive, where you will be given some questions and you have to write the answers. All 3 papers are of 90 minutes each with maximum marks of 100. There is going to be a gap of 60 minutes between paper 2 and paper 3. So paper 1 and paper 2 are going to be held simultaneously, one after the other, and after paper 2 a gap of 60 minutes, 1 hour for lunch and then paper 3. The centers are not very important. Okay, the fees is not important, all these things are not important, so you can skip these things. Now let's come to the syllabus, which is the most important part here. The syllabus is, this is the overall syllabus, overall pattern of exam, paper 1, paper 2 and paper 3, number of questions 65 in paper 1, okay, total of 100 marks, and approximately 9 to 10 out of which 5 questions will be answered by the candidates. This is going to be on the lines of UPSC. Or a better classification would be the older method of RBI before 2015, how they used to ask questions in phase 2. So that is how this paper is going to be set. Okay, now let's come down. There will be negative marking also. Paper 2 is important here because paper 2 is of English. Paper 1 and paper 3 can be written in Hindi. Okay, so paper 2 has to be written in English. Sorry, it cannot be written in Hindi. And paper 1 and paper 3 can be written in both Hindi and English. Okay. Now let's come to the syllabus part. Okay. So the first one is paper 2, which is eligible or the same for all. It will include essay, Prezi, comprehension, business or office correspondence. These 4 things have been specified here. Nothing else is going to be asked from this area. The second one is your finance. Let's go through the finance syllabus. So paper 1, objective test on the following topics, finance specific questions on RBI guidelines or circulars. So RBI website, RBI website has to be mucked up completely. Questions on Basel norms and risk management principles on credit risk, market risk, liquidity management and balance sheet management, operational risk, stress testing, questions on financial accounting. So this is also important, financial accounting, which is not a part of or not asked in detail in grade B, DR, direct recruitment, is going to be asked here in detail through financial accounting. Paper 3 will be subjective in nature and it will include the following. Now this is going to be very tricky. If you are in a bank and if you have a master's degree, then it's going to be easy for you. Analyzing a credit proposal and giving comments on whether to sanction it or not. So analysis of credit proposal, here in ratio analysis, will become important, will hold importance. Analyzing sanction proposal and account statements and arriving at correct account classification. So identification of NPAs, what are the rules and how you can identify whether an account is an NPA or not. Analyzing the business strategy, ICAAP documents and arriving at risk perception of the bank. So this is also important. Analysis of an investment proposal and giving comments. So this is a part of investment banking. It is identified whether a company or a proposal or a portfolio is worth investing in or not. So this is also going to be done majorly through ratios. So detailed understanding of ratios is going to hold very high importance here. Okay, so these are for finance. For data analytics, probability, statistics, distributions, hypothesis testing and confidence intervals, correlation, copulas, linear regression, modeling cycles, MA, AR, ARMA models, very detailed. Risk modeling, again, almost the same syllabus, including risk management, market risk, operational risk, stress testing, similar to finance. So finance and data analytics, both are combined here. Forensic audit, fundamentals of forensic accounting, frauds related concepts, red flags, IT Act vis-a-vis business laws. A little easy if you have already done with these things, otherwise not possible. Professional copy editing, if you have specialization in copy editing, then it should be easy for you to understand this. Then last is human resource management. Okay, so in HRM, the following is going to be asked. First of all, HRM, that we've already covered in DR. Functions and scope of HRM, covered this. Components of HRM, role of HR executives, international HRM, organization behavior, leadership, decision making, interpersonal and group processes, organizational dynamics, development, need for HRD, strategies and systems, career planning and growth, competency mapping, performance and potential appraisal, coaching, mentoring, training and development, compensation, incentives, motivation, morale. All these we have already done. This means the entire book of organization behavior, entire book of HRM and organization theory to some level, because only some things are mentioned here out of organization theory, not the entire syllabus is mentioned here. Human resource planning, process and functions of human resource planning, forecasting, job analysis, all part of human resource management till here. And then you arrive at industrial relations, which is something new, not covered in or not asked in direct recruitment, RBI grade B, DR. It includes industrial relations, concept and scope of IR, approaches to IR, trade unions and associations, collective bargaining, employee participation, employee welfare, grievance handling, dispute resolution, disciplinary laws on industrial relations, working conditions, wages and social security, emerging trends in HRM. So still here, working conditions, wages and social security. This is all a part of industrial relations, and I think it's going to hold a lot of importance. At least 3 questions out of 10 questions are going to be from industrial relations in paper 3, and also in paper 1, out of 65, I think 10 to 15 questions are expected to be coming out of, to come out of, out from industrial relations. That's why it's important. You should not ignore this. Manner of conduct, as I said, paper 1 and paper 2 will be held together, then a gap, then paper 3. And the exam dates might be modified. Right now it has been decided as of now, 29 September 2018. So this is all for the new vacancies which have been released, a total of 6 posts with a total of vacancies amounting to 60. If you are eligible, please apply, and I'll try and provide as much guidance as possible, especially related to IR and human resource management and finance, whatever can be done. There's a lot of syllabus taken from CIB in finance, whether it is identification of stress, NPS, stress testing, or investment banking. Those things have been taken from CIB and GIB syllabus to some extent. So we'll be having a look at that also, but we'll try and have a look at it after 7th September. Immediately after 7th September, we'll try and work on these two areas, finance and HRM, for the next 15 days and try and help you out to the maximum level possible so that you can write the examination with confidence.